What would that look like, a war between Hezbollah and Israel?
Well, the first thing, Ash, is that we hope it's not a war. I think Israel and Hezbollah and Lebanon in general hope it's not a war. I don't think anyone's going deliberately into a war. We saw some rare good news when Iran launched a series of rocket attacks against Israel earlier this year. Israel made a very calculated and very limited response. It sort of basically left a calling card outside the zone of the Iranian nuclear operation, saying we can come back and get you if we want to. We're not doing it right now. So hopefully that same restraint, that same sort of symbolic exchange will apply in this case. So it may be an air campaign. It may be that Israel extends bombing into southern Lebanon, striking Hezbollah targets, and then draws a line and says, that's it. We'll go further if we have to, but this is a reminder not to do anything further. I think that's what everyone hopes for. The danger here is that it slips out of control, that it escalates in a way that people don't wish for, haven't planned for, and then can't control.
Well, as you point out, war is something nobody ever wants, but, and especially after 10 months of war in Gaza, surely Israel would prefer not to open up another front. I mean, where are they at in terms of capabilities?
Yeah, that's a really good point, Ash. They're really in a bad way. I mean, Israel has been shocked by that traumatic terrorist attack on October 7th by Hamas. The IDF has not done well in Gaza. It's struggled to deal with the Hamas problem. Of course, it's been a human tragedy in terms of the civilian death toll. But the IDF doesn't look like it's in control. Its troop discipline is poor. There's many accounts of human rights abuses. So this is not a moment of strength for the IDF. The government, of course, is in disarray, a very unpopular prime minister who seems determined to keep conflict going so he can stay in power. And now this time frame, we have elections in November in America. Bibi Netanyahu presumably, certainly wants Donald Trump to succeed. So there's reason to believe he may try and game things out and play for time until the November election. This is to say that there's no rational case for the IDF going into southern Lebanon, because the IDF is really in a weak situation. It can't afford a conflict on another front, even if it's not a full-scale war. And yet politics may cause that to happen.
And in terms of Hezbollah, how organised is that group? How strong are they?
Well, you know, a quick history. Israel laid siege to Beirut in 82, fighting the PLO, if you recall, you know, back in the day. That saw the birth of Hezbollah, backed by Iran, and it made it a very powerful group. Then in 2006, just 18 years ago, in July 2006, Israel was drawn into a conflict in southern Lebanon against Hezbollah. That conflict went for a month. Israel said it had really, you know, done great damage to Hezbollah, but Hezbollah survived. The point is that today Hezbollah is much stronger than it was in 2006. So these military operations have actually had perverse outcomes. Hezbollah is thought to have a force strength of as many as 100,000 troops, including reservists, and to have many long-range, including ballistic missiles supplied by Iran that could strike anywhere in Israel, as well as many shorter-range and often very inaccurate missiles, which probably explains the tragedy of this kids being killed on the football field. Given that Israel has struggled against Hezbollah in the past, and given that Hezbollah now looks at its strongest point ever, backed by Iran, of course, this is the context of a proxy war with Iran, you really wouldn't want to start something, because it's not clear how well the IDF could deal with this, particularly given it's so exhausted and fatigued after this 10-month conflict in Gaza. So, yeah, we don't want to find out how strong Hezbollah is, but it looks like it could be a real match for the IDF.
Yeah, he's hoping it doesn't get to that. Greg Barton, always appreciate your analysis. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks, Ash.